About a year and a half ago, I made a Roblox game and released it, and it was pretty successful. However, the team all fell apart right when it released, so now we're remaking it, and we're going viral. Guys, the game is turning out pretty good so far. Today we need to build a farm zone. Where is it? This third zone, there we go. And once this one's built, look how far along we are within the map. I'd say we're pretty close to an alpha release. This game did so good back in the day. Look, even a cat played the game. Absolutely nuts. But today we're gonna build the farm zone, and that means we'll have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 zones done. I'll probably get to about 12 before I release the game. Let's go ahead and take a snip and draw a pig. Oh yeah, guys, don't you see? First off, incredible artist, I know. This is our idea for today, and once again, we want to keep everything that cute theme. So I guess first, we're gonna need some assets. The first thing I want to do is some hay bales, and I don't know if I want them square or rounded. I think rounded is gonna be better, at least for the overall aesthetic of our game. Let's go to 12 sides, shade smooth, auto smooth, and I want 2 of these. First thing we are going to do is inset this, and we're gonna try to add just a little bit of shape to it. Like, it just needs something. All right, that's not too bad. And that could be our rolls sort of before they get rolled, if that makes sense. Or tied, I guess. Then we will just duplicate it, add in 2 loop cuts, scale those down a little bit, bevel those just like this, face select, and extrude along face normals. Now we have one with a band as well. Not too bad. Next thing I think would be awesome to add is some sort of a turbine. We're gonna keep this at 12 because I think that's a good spot. Scale this quite a bit up and scale it in, then just thin everything out. Now for the top, I guess we will put another cylinder, rotate it, slap it up here, and then I think we'll scale this side down and do a slight bevel on this side. Maybe on the other side as well. Yeah, that doesn't look too bad. That's not too bad. The next thing I want to do is a super, super easy thing. Scale this down, SX. Bring the top down in a little bit and bevel. But I only want to bevel the side. Perfect. That will be like a dirt hill type thing. We could have plants on top. A little farm gate is what is next on the agenda. And heck, we might as well add a little bit of uniqueness to those side things as well. Alright, there's a couple other things I need, but I think we already have them on the map, such as border pieces, trees, grass models, stuff like that that we can reuse from earlier. I'm gonna texture all this stuff, and I'll see you guys in studio. Alright guys, with all of our assets here named and colored, I want to do one more thing that's gonna help this game feel just a little bit more alive. Let's go ahead and put a script inside of this part. There's better ways to do this, I'm sure, but I am still a noob, so I'm just gonna make this rotate. Let's first define our turning speed. Alright, local turning speed equals 2. Then we need to do a little bit of a loop. The old wall true do, dare I say. Alright, this should work. I might have gotten the axis wrong, but I think I got it right. Let's run the game and hope this is spinning. It is! There we go, that looks nice. Alright, so that'll add a little bit of life into this farm zone. All that's really left is getting it built based on our drawing. We're gonna save these terrain pieces for absolute last. Those will fill in empty space. And we're gonna put our drawing on our monitor below so we can actually look at it as a reference. All right, first things first, I wanted 2 of these pretty big over here. One like that, and the second one a little bit smaller and maybe pushed over a bit. And we're gonna put those on top of a part, which will just kind of look like what got rolled up. In fact, we're gonna have to use a couple parts so we can round this corner without going into the actual play area. Make sure to anchor that, and let's set a color, something, maybe a little orange here. That's tough. I think something around here works. Let's go ahead and try to find a texture for this as well. That'll work at least for now. Then I wanted to guard it off with some fences, which we will place 2 of those. And of course, add a little bit of rotation to each one so it doesn't feel so stagnant. Looks like I wanted to have a windmill back here as well. I do want to scale those up quite a bit. And once again, add some rotation. Guys, really all that's left is placing these assets. I'll just see you when I get them placed. It's probably going to be kind of boring to watch. You know, I knew there was going to be a day that came where I forgot to switch my webcam border from whatever program I was using to the new program I'm using. So without further ado, Roblox Studio Border. There we go. So this is coming along quite nicely. I need to check and see if you're actually going to be able to get into the building while flying the UFO. Because if not, that could be a bit of a problem. So I'm going to just take it over and place it inside the spawn. And then at least I can check. I will say, for any of you guys who are excited to play this game, oh yeah, you can fit so easily. And it's like nice and spacey, I like that. For anyone who is excited to play this game, it is fully scripted and pretty much ready for release already. The only issue we have at the moment is balancing, so if any of you guys would like to be testers for the game, let me know in the comments below, as well as your Discord usernames, because we are trying to assemble a little bit of a testing team, and once that's done, and we're able to just actually test the game and get balance perfectly sorted out, we'll be able to release this thing. There is one more thing I want to add, and I've done it for pretty much every single map, and that is these, like, sand hills. Of course, they won't be sand for say in this zone. It'll be more like hay. But I do think they add a lot of life and just help a lot with the flatness of the map. Like, look at that. Already, another detail. So we're going to add one over here as well. Maybe one in this back corner. You know, we should try to just replace this flat piece with this, because then it'll look a lot less just ugly. Yeah, something like that I think looks pretty decent. Now, the only things I'm not happy about this zone are is the barn itself. I may need to rebuild that. It just looks too blocky and not really too aesthetically pleasing. And I do need to figure out a different way to sort of make the walls. Almost copy and pasting borders would look better, but I don't want it all to be the same as every other simulator. Alright guys, I almost did it again. This was editing RoBuilder, and I was like, bro, there's no chance I can leave the map like this. I do it so much, where it's like I gotta get a video out every day, or at least I try to, and I half-heartedly attack, I almost was non-PG, I half-heartedly attack whatever I'm working on. And it often makes people think like, dang bro, RoBuilder's trash. And I'm not the best builder, but I'm definitely not trash. So, I just remade the barn. I wanted a bit of a different aesthetic. Obviously, it just stuck out like a sore thumb. I mean, look at this. It literally, this is gonna be a game changer. It's gonna look so much better. And then another thing that I forgot was the silos. But now we have the silos and the barn. I didn't wanna go fully inside anymore. I just want the egg to be right in here, and you don't have to go in a building, because that is a bit weird. I also already textured this barn, looking pretty decent. I do need to texture the silo. A nice little gradient, just like this. Let's grab the little cross lines that we got. Perfect, and let's just drag those up. Not bad. Let's get this stuff into studio and see how it looks. Alright guys, I just got the new barn placed, and wow. Wow. It just takes some time, and you can make something somewhat decent. This looks so much better than the last one did, and fits the total aesthetic of the game a lot better. I also got the silos placed on the other side, so we no longer have those ugly walls, and I made these a little bit different in sizes. I should also switch these around. For the simple fact, we have the taller stuff on this side already, and I don't want it all to be like the same. There we go. This zone is definitely looking so much better with just a little bit more effort. Now, we have these egg one, weak pets. That'll say something else in the game, of course. We have these over the eggs, but I kind of want to have something on the building. I think maybe the word farm and then pets. We'll try it and see how it goes. But I don't think there's any great fonts in the 3D text tool. We're going to try. I mean, I guess we can't go wrong with luckiest guy. It kind of just works for most things. Let's get that placed kind of centered on the sign. I did off-center the sign a little bit while making it just because I think it looks more unique. But pets works right there, and then we'll add one more word that just says farm. We're gonna make this one pretty big, and I think it would be cool if we didn't have it as white. At least one of these words needs to be changed a little bit. So maybe we'll keep farm as white, and then change this one to the same sort of brown as the little bullet point. Yeah, I think that looks pretty good. Definitely a lot better than it did a moment ago. Now we can hop into some questions. Question number one, whatever happened to the Capture the Flag project you were working on? Guys, it is coming back. The only thing that happened is I didn't have a scripter for the project. However, my mindset has slightly shifted and I'm gonna be trying to script the project myself. Is this a good idea? Is this a bad idea? We'll find out soon. But this way I can have you guys give ideas for the game and I can put them in without needing to jump around everywhere and try to find help. I would honestly love to do a project that's fully community driven. As in your ideas for maps, scripting, literally everything, and it's gonna teach me a lot as well and give you guys sort of the perfect project. Role Builder, can you make a tutorial of how to make an FPS game like Frontlines? No. I'm not that skilled. I can't script guns. I can't model guns. I certainly cannot make a game as realistic as Frontlines, at least yet. No, it's just, it's out my wheelhouse. But guys, that is going to wrap up today's video. If you did enjoy and want to see more content like this, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Have a great day. Later.